time history data for my run-up looks pretty good. My acceleration data looks nice. Don't seem to have any clipping. I'm gonna look at my RPM. That's pretty smooth. I think I'm ready to process it. This waterfall plot looks terrible. I think my data was contaminated by electrical noise, because this is 60 hertz. Yep, and this is about 180, a multiple of that. And I gotta fix this. So to filter out this 60 hertz and 180 hertz, I think I'm going to need to use a special filter called a Coleman filter. Coleman filter is way sharper than a FIR or a IIR filter. It's going to be able to remove both of these frequencies related to electrical noise, the 60 hertz and 180 hertz, without influencing to a large degree this first order or this third order information that I also need in my results. So the first thing I need to do is turn on a special add-in called harmonic tracking. This is going to allow me to access the Coleman filter option. After I turn that add-in on, all I need to do is go down to the time signal calculator, go insert function, and I can actually sort my list and just look at the ones related to conditioning. If I go down, I have two new options: Coleman frequency cut and Coleman order cut. We're just going to focus on the Coleman frequency cut today. Hit OK. Now I have to specify which time history I want to filter. Well, that would be my CH1, my acceleration data. So I'll type that in. And I have to choose the frequency that I'm filtering. Well, the first one is 60 hertz. And I have to specify a harmonic confidence. That's related to how sharp the filter is. For right now, we'll just leave the default value of 200. The Coleman filter is very unique because it actually creates a separate time history of just the filtered noise. So why don't we name this 60 hertz? And we're going to need to create a second one to filter out the 180 hertz. So once again, we'll press insert function, conditioning, go down to Coleman frequency cut, hit OK. CH1 again, and this time the frequency we're going to filter is 180 hertz, and we'll leave the harmonic confidence the same. Hit OK. We'll give this a name. We'll call this 180 hertz. And now we need to subtract these two separate time histories from our original CH1 time history. So it'll be CH1 minus CH3 minus CH4. And it's just red because we haven't calculated it. And we'll call this corrected. So we can hit calculate. And now we have a new time history, CH5. That's our corrected time history without the electrical noise from the 60 hertz or 180 hertz. Now we can quickly see how that looks by going over here to our quick spectral map, changing from single to double vertical. We have CH5 selected, and let's set our resolution for 2 hertz. Hit calculate, and we can see the 180 hertz as well as the 60 hertz have been removed, but we can still see that there's still some small influence on our third order frequency content. So what we can do is actually make our filter sharper. So if we go back here, instead of 200, let's go 2000, and we'll do the same thing for the 180 hertz. Calculate again. Once again, display it. Calculate. And now we can see we've completely removed the 180 hertz as well as the 60 hertz with minimal influence to the surrounding order data that we want to keep in our results. And just so that you know how the trade-off works, increasing the sharpness of the filter just affects how quickly the filter can respond to changes in amplitude. Being that as we look at our original data, our amplitude is pretty constant throughout the run-up, so it's no problem to increase the sharpness of our filter.